everyone. Thank you for joining me on Heather D's LNA. And it is kind of a cloudy day, but you know what? I'm still feeling bright and sunny. And guess what? It is just me and my boys. And the one in the back is kind of asleep. Yes, we are doing a nice little weekend getaway. Yeah. And it is going to be so much fun. So, since I work in the hotel industry, for the Hilton to be exact, I have a free coupon to stay one night in one of the hotels in Indiana. So, I figured this is the perfect opportunity to make this a nice little weekend getaway for my boys. Because, you know, with the whole pandemic and not being able to really get out, I figured, you know what? Let us go. And let me see if I can find this coupon that I got this past Christmas as a complimentary stay at one of the Hiltons. And sure enough, they had openings. And now we are about to go there and have some fun. Now, of course, the pools are still closed. So, you know, we can't go swimming or anything. But you know what? Just to get out the house, I'll tolerate it. So, as we take this little trip down to Indiana, stay tuned for more video clips and little adventures that we plan to have along the way. We have finally made it to our hotel.
Let me show.
This is our hotel, Home 2 Suites by Hilton. And it is lovely. We got our room checked in for the second floor and can't wait to get inside. We have gotten checked in and look at this. Isn't it beautiful? This is Home 2 Suites. It is gorgeous. And of course, the all-you-can-eat, you know, the breakfast buffet is not available at the moment. But we are about to go up to our floor. Uh-oh, wait a second. Let's check out. This is the exercise room that she said is open and available. But the pool is not available. But look at this exercise room for those who wants to do exercises. All right. Okay, we're on the elevator going to the second floor.
Fire. There's no fire.
The color scheme is lovely. Look. 220. It is nice. He found our room. So we're in our room. This room is lovely.
This is
let me show you. So we walk through the door and this is our kitchen area. So we have a full-size refrigerator. So I will be going to the store to get some snacks for the weekend. We got dishes. We have a nice microwave here. We have the drawer. Azariah, can you please move your stuff out the way? Oh, with silverware and cutting. Let's see. Oh, he's washing his hands. Oh, look at that. Everything we might need. Oh, look at that. Little toaster oven and colander. Okay, let's see what's up under the sink.
We have a towel.
Garbage can. Of course, the coffee maker. And then our coffee cups and glasses and everything. And is this the... Oh, dishwasher. All right. Then, of course, we have a pull-out table here. Doo-doo. Wow, look at that.
And, of course,
this is nice. Gotta push that back in. As well as this chair. Then we got the TV, and of course, we got a nice sofa bed here. Azariah, a little wet pants and everything. And we got the curtains to close up for privacy and make it like a separate room. Isn't that awesome?
No privacy anymore.
And then we got these beds.
Nice comfy beds.
Look at
and our closet, of course, with iron. And we can close it. So that way we don't have to see everything. So it is time to start unpacking.
This place is nice. And it was free.
Thank you, Hilton. I am such a happy employer. I forgot to share with you our bathroom. So this is our shower area. And look at that. Look at that. Nice. Hello. And all the towels, which is cool, which is cool. Little washcloths, which is cool. Home Too Sweet says it's for a hair dryer in case your hair gets wet. Nope, that doesn't open. Oh, and then that does open. All right. And then, of course, we got our little complimentary bar of soap, body lotion, and conditioner. Isn't that lovely? La la. Okay, back to unpack. I got to share this with you. I just noticed that.
So, it provides you with a nice shower gel and a shampoo instead of the little tiny complimentary ones. So, all you have to do is just push that button if you want shower gel or push if you want shampoo. And that way, all they got to do is just refill those containers. That is awesome. Nice little upgrade.
Okay, so we have gotten all checked in and unpacked at the hotel. So, now we're about to get some little food and stuff to put inside of our refrigerator. They do offer the breakfast bags, like I assume, you know, pretty much assume that they pick up some, probably some like little waffles or something that we can also prepare in the room since they do give us a toaster oven. And that way I can, you know, make a little something or something for us. Nothing big, but you know, we can add to what they give us for breakfast. And I do also plan to get, you know, a little, probably 6-pack of bottles of water. And some more little snacks for us to have in our room. But we will be hitting up Chick-fil-A. My boys have never been there, so I'm about to treat them to something good. Okay, so we are in line to get our Chick-fil-A sandwich. And I'm going to show you how long this long is. All for a sandwich. I thought Popeyes was bad. I guess they're still doing the competition thing. I don't know. Okay, so this is where we are. We're still on the road, and we're trying to get to Chick-fil-A. Yeah. Chick-fil-A. That is how long it is. So, all for a sandwich. We could have went into a restaurant, but... this is a little getaway, so I guess it's worth the wait for now. Tomorrow, we will not do that. A shame. A shame, a shame. All for Chick-fil-A food. And we would have gone into the mall to the Chick-fil-A, but the mall closes at 7. And, of course, Chick-fil-A closes at 7. So, yeah. So, this is the one that's closed at 10 o'clock. And you see where we are. Okay, so we are not going to wait. We are going to come back to Chick-fil-A because I'm not about to wait no hour in line for this sandwich. We're going to come back in line later. We got to try to hit up Aldi's before they close. They close at 8 o'clock. It is currently 6:55. Yeah. So we're going to go to Aldi's, pick up a few food and snack things to have in our room, and then we'll get back in line. That way we can go straight to our hotel room and don't have to worry about dealing with these crowds of people. Okay, so we just got out of Aldi, and so now we are about to get back into line and back in line for Chick-fil-A. And this time the line is not in the street, so we are very happy about that. We're a little bit closer to the building than before, so I'm kind of glad that we did, you know, go to Aldi's. This is our location. We're close to Chick-fil-A. So, a little bit closer. Hooray! Than before. Now, I noticed that they have two lines. And from what I have read, the line that is further to my left is for people who have placed their order online through the Chick-fil-A app. And the line that I am in is for the drive-thru. So, I don't have a Chick-fil-A app because there's no Chick-fil-A for where we are. But that is a good piece of information to know, like if I'm ever in this area again. Well, we are now closer. We're actually under the Chick-fil-A carport. And they have ladies and people standing outside to place your order, so you don't have to be holding up line so much with the drive-through talking to the machine. You got a physical person taking your order, and then they put it into the machine, and then they send it to the inside. And then when you drive around to pay, you get your food. So I'm liking this. I'm liking this. And my son and I, ex-tired Randy XX or whatever he got going on for his YouTube channel, we got the spicy chicken sandwich with lemonade. And for my little one in the back, I got him a chicken fingers meal with lemonade. And we want to try out these macaroni and cheese. Keep hearing people talking about they got the best macaroni and cheese, so I ordered a medium size. We're going to see how this macaroni and cheese do. Okay, we're back in our rooms, and we're getting ready to chow down on our food. How it tastes, Azariah?
Delicious.
10 out of 10, he said. He got his chicken fingers or waffle fries and, of course, lemonade. Mm. And he got his with this macaroni and cheese. Yeah, I got some of that, too. I can't wait. Everybody is enjoying their meals. Not for me to get comfortable and enjoy mine. Kids are in chill mode, in pajamas, and so am I. I'm so comfortable, I'm looking like a granny here. Yes, I got on a duster. So, that means that's the end of this first night. So, until tomorrow, I will see you later. God bless. Hey, everyone. Today is part two of our little weekend getaway. And we are about to head to some stores, maybe check out a couple places where we've never been. But one of the first places my kids or my boys want to do is GameStop. So we're about to hit up the mall. Of course, everyone has their mask. I got my mask. So of course, we're trying to practice, you know, safety and everything, and of course sanitizer. So yep, so let's get this day going. Oh yeah, I didn't record all that beginning stuff because we woke up in chill mode and we had breakfast and just kind of relaxed around the room. So, I didn't want to see all that. So, stay tuned for the rest. Okay, so we are at the mall in Indiana. University Park Mall. I want to see what's going on around here. Everyone got their mask on. Pull it up over your nose. So, let's see what's going on. Okay, so we've already gone into what's that story? Just came from GameStop. They got what they wanted. He got his video game. He found a toy, as usual. So now we're in shoe department. See what's going on in here. What kind of sales we could find for the shoe department. Okay, so it got really super crowded up in that mall, and got what we needed. I got some shoes for my munchkin for school. Got him a little bit bigger, so he'll have them ready. And now we're gonna check out another set of stores before we go and get some wool. Okay, so we are currently in the store Tuesday morning. I don't know if you ever heard of that store, but it seems to have a nice little array of home decor at low prices. Kind of remind me of a Big Lots. Haven't been in here in about 15 years. So, but yeah, just thought I'd give it a quick look around and see what's going on. Some of their decor and items. All kinds of housewares. Like I said, kind of remind me of a Big Lots. So, not bad, not bad. Some of the prices kind of remind me of Big Lots. TJ Maxx, kind of a cross of the both. Don't really need nothing until I move into a house, but I like to get ideas, at least. Okay, so we have been to a few stores. We have gone to Sally's. I had to get some nail acetone. Have gone into Dollar Tree Tuesday morning, and of course City Trends. Now we are about to check out this store called Gordman's, which I've been meaning to check out for some years and never went in there. So we're about to see what they're all about. So, now we're at our final destination, which is Zing's. It is a Japanese restaurant, and my kids seem to love Asian food, and they do serve sushi, so we will be looking this place out. Stay tuned for some pictures, because I will not be recording myself eating, unless you want to see how the food is and get my feedback on it. Check out my other YouTube channel, Dishing With Me, Heather D 9708.
Hello, sushi.
Look at this. These are some crazy menus. It is now day 3, and we have checked out. Everything went well. We had a really nice time, enjoyed ourselves. We got our little breakfast bags, got all cleaned up, and now we are ready to head back home. So, if you really like this video, please click like, share, and subscribe. And be sure to check out my other YouTube channel, Dishing With Me, Heather D, 9708, to see where we went for our delicious dinner last night. So, thank you for watching, and God bless.